Under heavy security, a sea of runners takes to the streets of Pittsburgh. This year's marathon would bring new rules, new records, and sadly, one death. Good evening to you. I'm Shannon Perrine.
And I'm Matt Belanger. The race also brought a repeat winner. Channel 4 Action News reporter Andrew Del Grecco begins our marathon coverage tonight.
And with that, 30,000 people from 15 countries raced over 5 bridges and through 13 neighborhoods throughout the streets of Pittsburgh. Sky 4 over the marathon gives a pretty good perspective of the event's size this year, a record registration. Before and during the race, security was out in full force. Police dogs roamed the streets, sniffing out anything that might be suspicious. And advanced security technology we've rarely seen was evident from Boulevard of the Allies rooftops along the finish line and also down on street level in the crowds.
Congratulations, you did it!
But no trouble detected today. Organizers say the heavy planning was not overwhelming.
It wasn't really overwhelming. It was just more time consuming than anything, really going over our plans and going over them again and having several different meetings with different organizations in the city.
The spectators were safe, and so were the family, friends, and strangers they cheered on. Here's your winner, Kenyan James Kirwa, who ran the 26 miles in 2 hours and 13 minutes. A grueling task, but whether they were running for themselves or the people of Boston, these runners were up to that task. And for many, accomplishing the half marathon was reason enough to celebrate.
Yay, we're done!
With a little training, we're going to hurt tomorrow.
I have a goal to do a half marathon in half the states. This is my 14th state. Dressed as Wonder Woman. I forgot to include that detail.
As runners finished, the hundreds of medical professionals were on hand to treat the exhaustion. Dozens of people needed wheelchairs as they crossed the line. But EMS says the number of overheated runners was in check on this beautiful and mild temperature morning, on a day when each of Pittsburgh's EMS donated their overtime pay to Boston charity.
So we decided the best thing that we could do would be to donate all of our overtime wages to the Boston One Fund to help the victims that we couldn't physically be there to help.
From the Pittsburgh Marathon, I'm Andrew Del Grecco, Channel 4 Action News.
And sadly, one of the runners in today's half marathon went into cardiac arrest and collapsed along the course. 23-year-old Kyle Johnson of Franklin Park was treated by medics near Fifth Avenue and Jamonville Street in the city's uptown neighborhood. He later died at the hospital. His family tells us he had run a half marathon in New York City in March and had been in training. He graduated from Penn State 1 year ago today. Race director Patrice Matamoros released a statement saying, quote, "This is a loss for the entire marathon family, and our hearts and prayers go out to his family at this time." Now, in all,